Hi, let's talk about the celiac trunk. In this video, we'll describe the blood supply to the foregut, specifically the branches of the celiac trunk and their targets. The celiac trunk is the main blood supply to the derivatives of the anatomical foregut. It exits from the abdominal aorta at approximately the level of T12. Recall that the hiatus for the aorta, or the space through which the aorta travels from the thoracic part of the aorta to the abdominal part of the aorta, is also at T12. When we say trunk, many people are rather disappointed when they see this structure for the first time, because typically the celiac trunk itself is very, very brief. In fact, it may, on your donors, look as though these branches are originating from a common point of the abdominal aorta. There are three major branches: the left gastric artery, the splenic artery, and the common hepatic artery. Let's look at each of these as individual vessels. So the left gastric artery typically has a more superior departure from the abdominal aorta, and it is going to have branches which serve the liver and the abdominal portion of the esophagus, as well as branches that are serving the anterior and the posterior parts of the stomach along the lesser curvature of the stomach. The left gastric artery is going to anastomose with the right gastric artery at approximately the angular incisure of the stomach. Recall that angular incisure is an excellent landmark because there is an oblique plane that is going to prescribe the boundary between the body of the stomach and the pyloric part of the stomach. And so here we can see the left gastric artery anastomosing with that right gastric artery, which is a branch of the hepatic artery proper. And these both will serve the lesser curvature. The splenic artery is one of the more impressive arteries of the body, certainly the most impressive branch of the celiac trunk. It is rather large and tortuous, and it becomes more torturous with age. So the splenic artery tends to have a more left lateral and slightly superior course from the celiac trunk. It's going to run either adjacent to or through the pancreas on the way out to the spleen. And a large part of this artery is going to run posterior to the stomach, as we can see here. There will be branches to the pancreas that we'll discuss in a subsequent session when we discuss the pancreas, branches such as the dorsal and the greater pancreatic branches. But for now, let's look at the branches to the spleen, or the splenic branches, which are going to enter into the hilum of the spleen. There will also be short gastric branches. These short gastric branches are going to serve the fundus of the stomach. And then another very large branch called the left gastro-omental branch, also known as the gastro-epiploic branch. This is going to serve the anterior and posterior portions of the stomach along the greater curvature of the stomach, as well as the gastrocolic ligament, or the omental apron. It's going to anastomose with the right gastro-omental artery, which is a branch of the gastroduodenal artery, which is a branch of the common hepatic artery. So the Gastric arteries left and right serve the lesser curvature, and the gastro-omental or gastro-epiploic arteries are going to serve the greater curvature of the stomach as well as the omentum. Last and finally, from the celiac trunk, we have the common hepatic artery. The common hepatic artery is going to have a right lateral course. It consists of two major branches, the gastroduodenal, so gastro-stomach, duodenal-duodenum, and the hepatic artery proper, or HAP for short. So here we can see the hepatic artery proper taking a more superior course, whereas the gastroduodenal is going to take more of an inferior course. And we can see here's that gastroduodenal artery heading down or inferior across the duodenum there. There are several branches of the gastroduodenal artery that we care about. So we've already mentioned that right gastro-omental artery, which serves the stomach along the greater curvature, as well as the greater omentum. And then there are also superior pancreatico-duodenal arteries. So here we can see a posterior superior pancreatico-duodenal artery, and here we can see an anterior superior pancreatico-duodenal artery. These superior pancreatico-duodenal arteries are going to serve the duodenum as well as the head of the pancreas. And they're going to be important anastomoses with branches of the superior mesenteric artery, which we'll discuss towards the end of this video. The other major branch of the common hepatic artery, the hepatic artery proper, which we can see here, has a couple of branches. So we've already discussed the right gastric artery. That right gastric artery doubles back along the lesser curvature of the stomach. In dissection, it's very common for this artery to become avulsed from the HAP. And then we have the continuance of the hepatic artery proper going into and being conveyed by the hepatoduodenal ligament. That hepatoduodenal ligament is going to connect the duodenum to the porta hepatis of the liver. And it's going to contain three main elements: the hepatic artery proper and its branches, the hepatic portal vein, and the bile duct and its various tributaries. So let's follow the hepatic artery proper. It's actually going to branch into hepatic branches. So there's a left hepatic branch, and we can't see it. It's occluded here by the biliary tree. But there's also a right hepatic branch. And very frequently, we'll see the cystic artery, which is the artery which supplies the gallbladder, come off of the right hepatic branch. It can also be a branch of the left hepatic branch, a branch of the hepatic artery proper, of the gastroduodenal, or other parts of the either celiac or even SMA, but that is very infrequent. So finally, let's look at some of the anastomoses in the vicinity of the duodenum and the head of the pancreas, which will be between the gastroduodenal artery, representing the celiac trunk, and the superior mesenteric artery, which is the dominant blood supply to the midgut. Keeping in mind that the foregut and the midgut divide at the major duodenal papilla, the MAP. So it's natural that that this region, which is transitional between foregut and midgut, is going to see some sharing of blood between the celiac trunk and the SMA. So let's look at these together. So here's the gastroduodenal artery coming off of the common hepatic. Here we can see the posterior superior pancreatico-duodenal artery descending down, supplying the duodenum in the head of the pancreas. We can also see the anterior superior pancreatico-duodenal artery coming down as well. Here is the right gastro-omental. The SMA is here, so that's running just along that point, just behind the neck of the pancreas. And we can see that gives off an inferior pancreatico-duodenal artery. And that inferior pancreatico-duodenal artery will have both anterior and posterior branches. And those anterior and posterior branches of the inferior pancreatico-duodenal artery will anastomose with those anterior and posterior superior pancreatico-duodenal arteries to supply the duodenum and head of pancreas with blood. In addition, it's pretty common for there to be an anastomosis between these series of anastomoses and branches of the splenic. So here we can see an anastomosis between the anterior branches and the dorsal pancreatic artery here, coming off of the splenic artery. Very common. So we have discussed the blood supply to the foregut. The dominant blood supply is the celiac trunk and its three major branches, the common hepatic, the left gastric, and the splenic. This is your summary slide. I thank you for your time.